Welcome to the Entrepreneur Podcast, where we take a look inside the lives of the accomplished and successful businessmen and women. We'll get up close and personal with the founders of booming startups. So lean in and prepare to carry away something to skyrocket your own business. Please subscribe to our show and do leave us a review. It means a lot to us. Now, here's your host, Rajiv.
Hey listeners, welcome to the Entrepreneur Talk Show. This is a show where we talk about entrepreneurship and speak to great founders, investors and startups. Today we have with us Abhijeet Kumar, co-founder at Raincan. Raincan is a subscription-based prepaid service which provides everything you need for a scrumptious breakfast right at home. All the essentials like milk, bread, eggs, as well as other fresh produce like vegetables and fruit are provided under this model. As the company follows a hyper-local model, everything is available on order within a few hours. Welcome, Abhijeet.
Yeah, thank you, Rajiv, for inviting me in your show.
Just a brief intro before I ask you about the product. Abhijeet is an IIB grad and also a consultant at ISB. He previously was a solution architect at KPIT, principal consultant at Inspiraj, and also lead consultant at Fujitsu. Again, welcome, Abhijeet. Do fill in any gaps in the intro and do let us know what's going on in your world today.
Rajiv, so you have covered me well. So I have spent most of the time in supply chain consulting across various companies, and I have been traveling throughout the world.
Okay.
So solving their supply chain issues of various companies,
mm-hmm.
be in FMCG, be in manufacturing. So across the industry, I have been working.
Okay.
And I also had a couple of stints where we have tried two or three earlier startups also.
Okay.
So our first startup was itself in 2007. That was KisanBandhu.com. That was more on the agriculture mandi,
mm-hmm.
mandi that we started. After that, again, we also, around 2009, we also tried a company called Bits at Race, where we were preparing the CDs for examinations, right?
So
So for Bits Pilani and all, we used to prepare CDs and we used to sell. So that was also okay business. Then late 2011 and 2012, Munendra, who is my co-founder in Raincan also, and myself, we both started poly houses in near Bundi district of Rajasthan.
Okay.
What we were doing there, that we have created few poly houses, greenhouses, and we have been cultivating the cut flowers and selling into the northern India, and that business is still on.
So, oh, okay.
So that's kind of sustainable on its own. So
okay.
We still sell things from there. While doing that whole thing where we were doing all these flowers and then exotic vegetables and all, we realized that retail side probably we should look at where we can actually add value to the farmers also and take the things from lower side of the value chain and
bring
to customers with a fresh mindset and fresh produce, right? So when we say fresh, we really want to mean fresh in our current avatar of Raincan. So all these things are linked. So in 2007, we started with online mandi. Then 2011, which was again agricultural produce. And then again 2015, we started with Raincan as an app only. Right now, it's an app only.
Platform. Okay, yep.
Where we are dealing with most of the fresh goods on a daily basis.
Okay.
Goods, again, the categories mainly which we deal with is dairy, bakery, fruits and vegetables. And we have also introduced like dosa batter and that kind of
product. Okay.
As a fresh goods.
Okay.
So
before we enter the main product, any passions outside of business?
So most of the time it has been the same, right? So...
Uh-huh.
I have been either doing the job or trying the startup was the passion. So whatever time I was left with, I have experimented on different models and took the learning out. So that's what I have been doing. So I really don't know that any other passion if I can have. So there was a job, there was a startup. Uh-huh. I didn't have time to do anything
okay.
else. So it's since start.
Okay, so what inspired the idea for Raincan?
So I already gave the background.
Yeah, correct.
So the idea of Raincan, right? So what we throughout our stints with agricultural produce and all, I think, right, if you see in our daily life as of now, if you're a family or even you're a bachelor's, right, you always go to a big store, buy your weekly grocery, fruits, vegetables and stuff, and then you hold it at your home, right?
Correct.
In your fridge. And probably in 4 or 5 days, once you open up and you see that, okay, on backside of your fridge, there's some vegetable lying which has already got spoiled, and you have to take them out and then throw them, and then again refresh your fridge, or you have to keep cleaning your fridge probably every 2 or 3 months, right? And we waste a lot of fresh things mainly in that process. It could be from the dairy, it could be some paneer going spoiled or some vegetables going spoiled.
Mm-hmm.
So thing is, the idea is like we want to sell to customer a smaller quantity of these fresh goods, okay, on a regular interval. So when I say that our tagline is basically buy small, eat fresh. So what we want to achieve that if you have to cook your curry today or your dinner or lunch today,
yep,
whatever things you need for today, we want to supply you today, and then whatever you need for tomorrow, we will supply you tomorrow. So you don't have to buy everything upfront for another 4 days or 5 days. So for an example, right now on our app, you can even go ahead and order for a kg potato, and we will, you know, bring it to you.
Oh, okay.
So that's where we come in. Okay. And our supply chain also works like that. So we look at per customer frequency of buying, you know, per week. So
correct,
we have
correct,
customers
correct.
who buy at least 12 to 13 times a week, okay, with us. So 12 to 13 transactions they do with us in a week time. Okay, so they can get up in morning, they can order 2 goods from us, and they can by afternoon they top up some another two other products, and then by evening they order another 2 products, and everything combined we give them tomorrow morning, early morning.
Oh, the next day. Okay. So one basket.
Yes. Yes. Okay. We are not on demand.
Okay.
We are not, we are hyper local, but we are not on demand. So
got
I just
it,
wanted to clarify that. But like up till morning, 5 o'clock, you can order with us. We will still deliver you at 7 o'clock. So people who are ordering midnight, for them, probably we can be seen as on demand because we are delivering them in few hours.
Okay.
But people who are ordering at around 5 or 6 or 7 o'clock evening or 8 o'clock evening, probably we deliver them in the morning. And so we are into a planned demand. And the main part of our whole offering is subscription. So actually, we encourage people to subscribe these goods. So like you have milk, you have bread, you have eggs, you have banana, you have coconut water.
Correct.
And then you have these healthy drinks, right? So this all comes under very well under our subscription, where you can just go ahead and you can choose one of these products, and you can say that, okay, give me this product probably daily, the other product probably every third day, some product probably every week, you know, so that kind of frequency you can set on our app. So we have a customer who will buy milk daily, banana every second day, coconut water every day, you know, that kind of orders we get, okay? So you can subscribe to these products with us for a regular interval. And when you subscribe, we do not catch hold of you for a month or for a year. So we don't tell you that, okay, come ahead and pay me for a year subscription or something, and we will keep delivering you. So we do not hold the customer or the user for that.
Okay.
We still give you an ability to pause your service. Like you have started today, and after 2 days, you realize that, okay, you don't need milk tomorrow. So you can just come on the app and you can pause it. Okay,
oh,
pause
okay.
it for tomorrow. And that's another app. You don't have to put a request or something. It's everything is in the app.
Okay.
And you can just pause it. So tomorrow it will be paused. Automatically it will start from day after tomorrow. If you want to change the quantity, you want to add few more items into your order,
mm-hmm.
you can just do that. Okay. During this whole process, you just order, you don't pay. The
okay.
payment is payment. I'm just switching our talk.
Yeah, sure.
So for the payment, we give to our customer that they can pay using our wallet. So what you can do, that you can just recharge 100 rupees with us, and you can buy in that 100 rupees, you can buy milk, you can buy bread, you can buy even some of your groceries, 10 kgs atta, and also you can buy anything, whatever is an offer on our app. So currently the main categories which I already mentioned, we also give you the cooked breakfast. In morning we will give you like 60 odd rupee breakfast. So, and whatever categories we are doing in the morning, we are the only one in India who do this. Okay. And we are the biggest one in India who do this. So both things are true. And so for breakfast, right? So right now you have not many options, right? To eat for your lunch, for your dinner.
Correct.
But you will not have someone who will deliver you a breakfast at morning 7 o'clock or 7:30 for say.
Correct.
If you want to eat a dosa in morning 7:30 when you get up, you will not get it. We give you. So, but the only thing is, we are not on demand. So in the morning 7 o'clock, you get up, and if you put you look into my app and try to order, probably you won't be able to do. But before you go to the bed, you can order with us, and I will get it for you.
Okay.
So that's how it is.
So who is correct? So who delivers these products? You have people on staff or some contractors?
Yes. So we have various models, Rajiv, as of now. So. So we have our own fleet of approx 50 delivery boys who starts from our store timings, and everything starts from 4 o'clock morning. We have two centers in Pune, and everything starts from 4 o'clock morning. We have a logistics team, and we operate like a small marketplace also. So there are vendors for dosa mix. There are vendors for breakfast. Now we have an arrangement like... sometime we take care of, so broadly we have put our business proposition in 4 or 5 categories, where we say if we take care of product, we take care of procurement, we take care of payment, we take care of after delivery issue like customer cares and all. Okay, so they are the mainly 4 things. Okay, and then we take care of delivery. So 5 things all in all we work with, not depending on the product, depending on the categories. Let's take milk, we do all 5. Okay. For breakfast, we do 2 or 3 of them. So we deliver for them, we take care of payment, and we take care of customer care. Okay? Mm-hmm. And the important thing in our order size system, right? So if breakfast comes to your home, you don't have to open your wallet and give it to him. Okay? So you can pay it, right? So you can pay it in my wallet sometime later probably earlier. Okay? So the same wallet money you can use for a breakfast, you can use for your daily milk also.
Okay? So the wallet can be used for anything basically.
Yeah,
for all products.
On our platform.
Yes, correct.
So we do not do cross platforms. On our platform, whatever we introduce in terms of marketplace, everything gets solved. And depending on the vendor seller, we put that arrangement. So we give them seller that they're there. So, okay. So one interesting thing we do, we deliver you everyday puja flowers. Okay, so, subha 7 baje, we will come to you, to your doorstep.
These are very important things every day in India.
Yeah. So the things which we do, right, they're very niche. Okay. People need them, and there is a huge requirement for these items, for these requirements. This is completely unorganized sector as of now.
It is. Yeah.
So you will not find any other startup or any other company who will come every day and deliver you some 20 rupee vodka flowers.
Definitely. So you're doing only like morning goods, basically stuff we needed in the morning.
Yes, but. So we are strong in morning, but very recently we have also started experimenting on 1 or 2 slots in evening. But our everything is in morning as of now.
Okay.
So when we end our store, everybody else starts. So when we shut down our store, every other company.
Correct.
Okay. So most of the things are done by morning 10 o'clock.
Okay.
Everything.
Okay, great. So, and so who are the key people to take this project off the ground? I mean, it was just you and you, or you and your co-founder Munendra.
Yeah, so in the founding team, we are 2 people, and we also have an investor, Nidha Malpani, with whom we have raised some tune of 1 crore, like in November last year.
Okay.
So that's the management and the founder part. But we have a core team of operations, marketing, HR, accounts. So we have altogether 30 people team who takes care of all these activities, and then we have another 50 people. Logistics fleet who takes care of the delivery.
And they're all on payroll?
So this 30 people team are on payroll.
Mm-hmm.
The logistics is partly on payroll and partly outsourced, and that
okay.
So it's, because of our deliveries all concentrated in the morning, we also try to use the part-time basis people who can just come and deliver for us, and we pay them a fee. Okay, so that kind of thing.
So when you thought of the idea, how did you like start? Did you do an MVP or did you just straightaway take out the product?
No, me and my co-founder, we just went door to door and asked the customer that do they need milk, do they need bread. We started with some of the sample.
Uh-huh.
And we started from there. So actually we started.
So the app wasn't ready that time?
Yeah, no.
Okay,
so app,
okay.
We didn't know what customer wants.
Correct.
So we started with the customers first. We did some sampling, some exercise
mm-hmm,
with them.
Mm-hmm.
So we decided on the app once we already had around 300 customers, day 300 customers and 300 deliveries daily. So after that, all the learnings we took and then we applied them in the app.
Okay.
So whatever customer says is what the app is. So it's not mm-hmm. that we decided the technology and we gave it to customer.
Okay.
It was not the other way around.
Okay.
Customers decide for us and we just give it to them what they want. And so currently like we are delivering 2,000 deliveries every day.
2,000? Oh, that's yeah. Really good. Very good. And out of these 2,000, most are subscribers?
I would say 90% odd are subscribers, and then another 10% would be hoppins.
Oh, that's very good. Yeah. Okay.
So it's that way. And
so repeat customers almost 90%.
Very good. Mm-hmm. So we have a subscription model, right?
Yeah, correct.
And, this 2,000 deliveries, another interesting thing, this 2,000 deliveries we do in 2 or 3 areas of Pune. So we do not.
Okay.
Okay. And we have markdown, like on the ground level, we do a lot of work. So we have identified 200 odd societies
which
we can deliver.
Mm-hmm.
But societies are already listed on our app. So not only the society, their blogs and everything we list on our app upfront. So if you are a customer, you come to my app, you have to choose your society first. And when you are putting up the address, you have to choose the blocks given by us, not by you.
Correct.
What you put is only flat number. And this whole thing is required.
Mm-hmm.
The kind of things which we are doing, right? So we are delivering low ticket items to the customer.
Right? Mm-hmm.
Deliver low ticket items to the customer, the delivery cost has to be
correct.
So our one delivery guy at times, right? He can deliver 70 to 80 odd delivery in 2 hours period.
Mm-hmm.
Because that those customers are coming from max to max 200 meter area. So he just walks over deliver to everyone. Okay, so there are societies. Everybody in the society is our customer. There are societies like that.
Very good.
So in the areas where we operate, we can safely say we are the biggest one in terms of deliveries.
Very good. So you have around 4,000 to 5,000 odd products plus, I guess. And why only like dairy or breakfast products, etc.? Any reason for that?
No. So the reason is not decided by us again.
Okay.
So it's customer. So we keep So what customer wants, we give them. Okay. So Nariyal Pani, let's say that coconut water, right?
Yes.
We are the only one in India who can deliver you a coconut water every day at your doorstep. Okay. And that's a fresh coconut water. We just take it from the directly from the Kerala kind of thing. Okay. So we procure to that level. So the thing is, whatever customer wants, you know, that's why I keep repeating. So it was never like that. We say that, okay, these are the products we feel that customer will buy and we just put it and then customers buy or don't buy that. We don't know. So we always try to do survey. We have, we also assign relationship managers across areas.
Mm-hmm,
So every customer has an access to one of a known guy from our team. Okay, they will know that, okay, this guy is for me. He's from Raincan and he takes care of my small daily core things. Okay, few of things they are taking care of. Few of things I have to request them, they may take care of. Okay, so, you know, it, in that way. So the products also are growing in that way. And so far we are into products. So and we have increased. Okay, so like we just work on those things, you know, which which are needed. If somebody else is serving and the and customer is already happy with that, we don't get into that much. But wherever the gaps are, we are trying to.
Correct. Okay. Yeah. So now I also read somewhere that you're doing some preemptive analytics, forecasting on customers, etc. Right?
Yes. So as I said earlier, that I am from the supply chain planning background. So I have been using the world's best products around forecasting and planning. So we are applying those intelligence in our data sets also. Okay, and we also sit with, like as I said, that we have a subscriber base, so our data is very clean from the customers.
Correct.
We always have an idea that how much this customer will want in another 1 week or 10 days. And we suggest them on top up to not top up those orders. So they can even purchase one time, right? So they can just say, okay, give me 1 kg potato, they click one plus and they say top up and then it's confirmed. They don't have to go through the whole form cycle and payment cycle and all, okay? So whatever they need, they can just quickly do it. Now, for that need and all, we have a system where we predict that these customers may want these things because they have ordered these things in past, and these are their consumption patterns on which we try to focus, and we push that to the customer. And that also we do it through our marketing channel too.
Okay. So you can order via the wallet on the, your payments via the wallet on the website, correct?
Yes.
And you'll make a commission on each item, I guess?
Yeah. So in terms of now coming back to the assets, right, and the supply chain. So we procure most of the goods just in time because we are a subscription. So we already know that how much order I have to serve tomorrow. If I'm saying 2,000 orders a day, I know that tomorrow I will serve 2,000 orders. I don't have to wait, right, for a marketing scheme to come in and people will order or not. So I know already that, okay, this much order will be there. Probably 1-2% up and down in our orders. So we already know that this much we have to sell. We also have a predictive analysis. So everything gives us a very fair idea that how much I need tomorrow morning. So our order process to our vendors or our suppliers starts in the night. So after 8 o'clock or 9 o'clock, our all orders goes to the vendors. Every vendor comes to us or we go to them in the morning. We procure what customer wants. We deliver to the customers and we are done.
Got it.
So nothing we stock, nothing we store much, okay? But again, there are always some small issues like returns and all. So that will be part of 1% or max to 2% of our entire operations which we do, or entire categories which we do. So 1 or 2% probably will be lying on the stock, but rest all comes on demand from the supplier, and then we just deliver it to the customer.
Okay.
So there is nothing which we store.
So now you have competition in so many hyperlocal companies coming in like Grofers, Jugnu, etc. I mean, I guess what you told me, no one's doing these small items or these fresh produce items early in the morning. So how are you also different from these other products? I mean, these other companies?
So there could be crossover, right? So like we do breakfast, like cooked breakfast. So I don't know, so Grofers, right? So they may not do cooked breakfast, okay? And probably some other startup will be doing that, right? Now coming to the fruits, vegetables. So probably some other guy will be doing fruits, vegetables, right? And we are doing. So there is something common, something uncommon. Now the things where we differentiate ourselves is we have a subscribed customer base, okay? And we do, we deliver to them on a daily basis a low ticket items, okay? So we do not have, customer doesn't have to bother that he is ordering 20 rupee goods or 30 rupee goods, okay? We do charge them a service charge, but it's not in terms of 20 rupee per delivery or 50 rupee per delivery. If your order size is below 200 or if your order size is below 300, you know, those conditions are not on our app.
What we do,
a customer can, you know, order a 10 rupee charge from us, okay, and we delivered it to them. We look at those orders as a sampling, you know, so customer may try us. So normally it happens when customers come on board, they try us for 3-4 days. So we give them those trials, okay, and we allow them to, you know, check our services and all. But once they are done, the same charge we will deliver them to them every day for a month or for a year. So whoever has come to us since August, they are with us so far. So nobody has moved on. So our attrition rate is very, very, very less in terms of customers. So,
okay.
So that's where we are different, right? So we are absolutely different from any other.
Correct. So coming to funding, you all have raised, you all initially raised around 100K from a group of angel investors. Of course, one of them was Ajit. Anything after that, or you're on the road again to raise some more?
So after that, Aniruddha Malpani from Solidarity Investment Advisors.
Aniruddha Malpani.
Okay. So they have invested 1 crore in us. So that investment came in mid-November.
Okay.
Now we are looking out because as long as you are doing customer-facing business, so growth requires always...
Feet on street, yeah, correct. Yeah, correct.
Yes. So we are again looking out, but and the talk is also on. So let's see.
Okay. And any key partners? I read somewhere you have Nestle, all these guys partnered with you?
Yes, so we are, I'm not sure that how much I'm allowed to take the names, but
correct.
Yeah. So
whoever
we see,
you can, yeah.
Yeah, so whatever we see, right, that we have a strong partnership with all FMCG companies, and they have a different channels, right? So like a traditional retail is one channel, right? So like kirana stores, you know, they can sell their goods through kirana stores. Mm-hmm. Then you have a hypermarket, and no, I'm talking about the offline, right? So hypermarket store, so that's that comes under the modern retail where they through channel, and they also have an online channel where they try to push their products through the online retailers. So that's where we fit in. So most of the produce, most of the goods, which are branded ones,
come through
most of these branded companies.
Okay.
And we have a good relations with almost all of them.
Got it.
Another thing which we have, which we do for many companies right now, it's sampling. So when I say that, okay, this society has 200 people living in, 200 families living in, and all 200 are of my customer, this is the best place to, you know, sample your products, right?
Correct, yeah. Want test to
launch
it out.
Something, yeah. So if you want to launch something on the categories where we deal with, we even allow companies to, you know, sample out things, and we support them over there. And so every time, right? So for us, discount is not the word. It's always sample.
Okay.
So we do not run discount programs. We run sample programs for our customers. So we give them samples, you know, even for bakery or bread, we give them sample to eat. 2,000 people, they eat, they decide, and they order, you know. So it's like that. So there also we are having a lot of traction with all big companies, I would say. And they all are supporting us.
Very good. Okay. So moving out of business, Abhijeet, who influenced you most in life?
So in terms of people, yeah. So I have been influenced more by Mahatma Gandhi. So I have read him. I have not seen him, but yeah.
Correct.
Mahatma Gandhi has been the guy.
And what is some of the best advice you have been given?
So the advice is, most of the advice has come into the startup. So the best advice I have been given and I will give, that be patient, and patience pays, you know. So if you wait for some time, things will turn out if you are doing your honest.
Yeah, very true for startups. Okay.
Yeah.
So you have worked in different corporate jobs. When did you know you were meant for entrepreneurship?
Mostly from the first job. I started from Oracle as a first job, and mostly from that time I knew that, you know, I have to try something on my own and see how things work. So I have been, from then on only I have been, so 2007.
Okay.
So
okay.
I passed out in 2005, 2001 or 2 odd year I worked, and then I started out. So I have been in a startup since then.
Okay. And I mean, you have done various other startups before with moderate success, or some which failed also.
Yeah.
So was there any time where you just wanted to completely give up in this journey?
That time has not come yet.
Okay, very
good. I feel very excited about things. Uh-huh. Okay. And startups turns out to be good or bad, that probably how we execute it. But I don't take it on, that way. So it's... My partner, if you talk with Manu, probably he will talk, but I will repeat his words. So it's fun, you know. So that fun part is important. You know?
Yep,
you
can't
just change something, you know, and you just make it true. Okay, you believe into this, and this has to be true, and everybody will like this. So probably if you go with that attitude, probably you may feel like giving up. We do not go with that attitude.
Okay.
We like to try, you know.
Okay. So if someone wants to join Raincan, what's the first characteristics you'll be looking for in that person?
So in terms of our team and joining, so we are a startup, right? And at least for Raincan, probably the other company, I can give probably some other idea, but for Raincan, we are a retail startup. So we deliver goods 27 days a week. Mm-hmm. Okay, so we don't have holidays and all. So holidays, when I say we don't have a 2 days off and Correct. That kind of thing. So I mean to say that in a retail business, right, every penny counts. Okay, so we always look out for people who really understand the value of startup which is adding to them and the value of time and, you know, the work which they do. So we look for the hardworking people and with the right attitude. So probably the right attitude can bring that hardworking part. We are fine with that. Okay.
Okay.
So first, so these two things which we always try to just gauge that. Okay. So you can be fit in my team. Mm-hmm. If you are mm-hmm. just hardworking and you're honest, rest of the things we can, you know, work out together. We can learn. We can make mistakes. That's not an issue. The only thing is that you should be just ready to make mistakes, you know. So that kind of people we really like to, you know, work with. And we are the same ones.
Okay. And what's something, that's getting really, really excited at present? Any new launch or feature coming out?
So actually, every third or fourth day, we are excited on something.
Okay.
So this breakfast, it launched like a week back. Okay.
Ah, okay.
Another week, the cooked breakfast section. In another week or so, we will launch something else, you know. So in terms of categories launch in this thing, it just keeps happening and keep doing. The other thing I would really like to explore, which we are also looking out for the funds and all, I would like to try a different market than the Pune also. Mumbai is the place where we are another home city.
Easiest,
so. So Mumbai, we really want to, you know, try out the waters for our model. So that's where we are looking at.
And where do you see yourself and your business, let's say, in the next 2 to 3 years?
I think that we will be doing the same thing. The only thing which will change would be probably the scale.
Correct. Very important.
The learnings from the customers. So I think that's the two things which we will experience. And rest all will be, I think it will be same. It won't change.
Okay. And finally, Abhijeet, one last thought or piece of advice that you would like to give our aspiring founders and listeners?
In startups, right, a lot of times I will go a little away from my normal talk. So in startups, normally, you know, you see a lot of low and high in your experiments and all. But the first thing first, right, when you're starting up, or even if you're running a startup, just look out for your products, what fits to the market, you know. Spend a lot of time on that.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Believe in yourself first. Because today only we were also discussing again with my partner that, you know, something which you don't believe in, you know, that will never work. Even if you get a lot of money behind it or a lot of big team behind it, okay. So spend some time, you know, to understand what you are doing, okay. Don't make assumptions. Try and test it out. And then go ahead. I think that will definitely get you the success. That's what
Excellent.
I feel.
Excellent. Okay. And let our listeners know how they can reach you and also Raincan.
So they can reach me directly to my inbox. So that's abhijeet@raincan.com. So they can just drop me a mail. And we are like always open to have a coffee with anyone and everyone who is interested to know about us, to work with us. Or if they want us to work for them, that also it's fine. Right. So we are absolutely open. So me and Munindra, we are both are open. They can also drop a line to Munindra@raincan.com. We can always connect.
Okay, great.
Mostly we are in Pune and we also keep traveling to Bombay. So we can always connect.
Again, Abhijeet, thanks for taking the time to talk to us and inspiring our listeners to start their own ventures. And all the very best and success with Raincan.
Thanks, Rajiv. Thanks.
Do visit Raincan.com and visit us at theasianentrepreneur.com to get the show notes. And also please subscribe to our show in iTunes, TuneIn, Stitcher and leave a review on your thoughts about the show. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you for listening, and please subscribe to the show so you don't miss an episode. Our hope is that you are encouraged by what you've heard, and you can put these same concepts and mindsets to use with your own style. See you next time as we discover more about what it takes to be an accomplished entrepreneur. In the meantime, head over to theasianentrepreneur.com and check out show notes and other information to motivate you in your entrepreneurial endeavors.